Always ask someone you love before you put anything in your mouth.
I'm just glad you're doing this in the privacy of your own room.
And welcome to the LARPBook podcast. This is episode 37, 28th of June 2016. I'm Stuart Edwards, and with us tonight, as per usual, when I say per usual, not last time because everybody had buggered off doing things, apart from me who was here on my lonesome, we've got Rob incredibly in the shade there, Davis. And of course, Thomas, I think I am going to grow back my beard, Busby. he's just definitely going for the house stubble. He's, you know, like he didn't look enough like him anyway, you know. You go. It's a full house, yeah. It just means you can get away with being sort of really cranky and bloody horrible, really, isn't it? But then come up with brilliant sort of diagnoses, you know. This is going to be my setup again, isn't it? Let's try that. But you may get feedback on yourself, however.
Oh.
Yeah. Well, I can hear it, but it's fine as long as it's not like in the
okay.
recording.
So tell me, yes, yeah. Tell me, chat room, do you actually hear these two need to speak a little bit now? Come on, speak a little bit.
Oh, come on. Do we have to? Really? Yeah. Tom?
Yeah, we're coming through on Twitch now.
Yeah.
We're all good.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Excellent. Yay. So. If you two hear echo, sorry.
Yeah, it's fine.
Nothing I can do about it, quite obviously. Yeah. What I need is a good sound engineer. If you know a good sound engineer, point them in my direction, and they can say, get some proper kit.
So, that'll be £100.
That's right, yeah. Anyway, here's some cables. So,
short
anyway,
cables or long cables?
In tonight's show... tippy tappy combat. Hema and Larp. Okay. There's no way I'm going to get this one right. Schola Gladiatora.
I think that's it. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, I think you got it right.
Schlola. Larp arrows and you. Alcohol. And don't forget.
Please.
And don't forget that tonight's episode is brought to you by LARPIN at larpin.co.uk. Go there for all of your LARPing needs. And I do mean all of your LARPing needs. Fangs and everything. Fangs for the memory.
All your LARPing needs.
That's it.
Every one of them.
That's at larpin.co.uk. Right then, let's get some talky stuff going. Actually, I suppose I better, for those that don't know, good job fixed. Thanks. For those that didn't hear the first bit then, I'm Stuart Edwards. There's Robert Davis below me.
Hello.
And Thomas trying to be house again, Busby.
Hello.
In fact, as Rob said rather quite wittingly, he's going for the full house. Yeah, that almost feels like it needs that, doesn't it? Let's try that again, but louder.
That's great. Listen, you're a real hoot.
Yeah, there we go. So, let's start off by... should we start off with tippy-tappy combat, Rob?
Go on.
Let's get a rant on, shall we? Let's get a rant on.
We're early tonight with the rant.
Yes, oh, let's start with a rant.
Let's start with a rant, yeah? Because yes. I think that's rather important to get us in the mood for the rest of it, yeah? And by the way, everybody, just to let you know, I am actually sporting, although you can't see it properly at the moment. This will probably screw up my green screen, but let's...
Stand up.
I laughed before it was cool. the text is backwards, but that's because of the camera.
Fine.
You know, not to actually push the, our shop at all, but if you go across the red bubble, you can actually find our stuff, LARP, just search for LARP book. So, tippy-tappy combat, Rob. I know this is a particular bane of yours. It's a particular bane of mine.
Yeah, so it's something I really, really hate.
Would you like to start?
Okay, well, what? I really, really dislike it. Until sort of you got a LARP, you got a LARP combat-y scene going on, and then there's somebody who's not very far from you, just got a weapon, or let's call it a sword, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sort of going, stop.
Okay.
I mean, it just drives me nuts. I mean, there's no sort of visual cue. There's no role-playing the action.
Yeah.
And even though I know you could move a sword at a reasonable speed, I'm sure the best thing even a really sharp sword is going to do that is dip, is just going to give you a little graze. So there's no way that's going to be, okay, a cut maybe. Maybe draw some blood, but it's not going to really count towards killing you until a few days later when it gets infected.
No, that's right. It's basically going to be a flesh wound, isn't it?
Hey, they're just playing the long game, guys. That's what they're doing.
No, it's irritating as hell.
There's a long game, and then there's basically a mammothly long game. Right? You know, here, I'm going to give you a paper cut. In about 30 years, that might kill you.
Probably die of old age before then.
Yeah, pretty
but
much.
But you die.
Yeah.
That's the important thing.
I must be honest, it is one of my pet peeves, I suppose.
Yeah.
If you're going to hit me with a sword, hit me with a sword. If you're going to tap me with a sword, guess what? I'm going to completely and utterly ignore you. It's as simple as that. Because a tap like that, even leather armor, well, that's not going to get through leather armor. It's simple as that. At the very minimum, it's just going to make that leather armor look perhaps a little bit cooler.
If it was
a real sword, you know, give it a bit of battle damage in that respect. But yeah, for the players out there that decide that tapping me with a sword is going to have any sort of problem or inference, guess what?
No, because I just feel that if somebody's going to hit you with something, it has to feel like a hit, and you have to be able to see, even if they're too fast for you to react to or even see properly, that's fine, because they're still role-playing the attack.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah, role-play the attack, definitely. Ooh, there's a cup of tea coming my way. Thank you very much, sweetie.
God, look at that service.
Mm. Oh, that service.
With a smile.
No tip? I mean,
you see, Karen. Yeah. Karen's waving with the wrong hand. Try that one. There we go.
That's the right one. Hey, Karen.
She's forgotten how cameras work. Thank you very much for the tea, sweetheart. Oh, that's good. That's good. Okay, right. The way to combat this, sorry about the pun, I suppose is training.
Mm-hmm.
Training and education. If people are going to try to tap on things, etc., then, well, yeah. But you've also got to teach. I think this is where the biggest problem lies in the beginning. What's the first thing we tell people to do when they're in combat with a sword?
Yeah, pull a punch.
Pull your blows.
Don't hurt anybody.
Yeah.
I mean, Embassy Rap does have a fantastic sort of safety record.
Yeah.
It really does. I mean, I've never seen an actual weapon injury in 20-odd years of role-playing.
Yeah, I agree. Not injury, perhaps a few sort of bumps, but not an injury.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, I've seen people, I've been bruised by a sword, but that's not going to be an injury. It's just a little bit of a bruise.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. See, I think the people that, I don't know, this is just generalizing, but I think the main people that do it are probably new ones because they don't know how much force they can actually put behind a swing. So they err on the side of caution and just go, I don't want to swing too hard, and it's possible it's just something that they learn. I mean, I know I did. I know I was really cautious when I first started. I didn't want to hit hard at all because I was like, oh, God. Well, one, I wasn't using my equipment, so, God, I don't want to break this sword. And another one, I don't want to hurt the other person. We're here fighting and having fun, but obviously you don't want to hurt them. But the more LARPing I did, the more I understood, well, you know, you could give a bit more to it. It's not going to hurt them, you know. They have to actually realize you are hitting them for a start. You know,
And definitely,
I have to be able to notice the blow to take it.
And definitely in the frenzy of combat, then let's say, because you know, usually play a monster, as you know, and if I've got 30 people attacking me, then if someone's tapping me, I'm not even going to know it. Right, no, simple as that.
I'm not even going to notice that. It's going to go right off your radar. Hello, chat. What are you up to?
Hey, Pete.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, it could be. I mean, I suppose some people would do it because it could be advantageous. Because if you could full length of your arm and only tap them like that, then obviously they've got length on you, so technically to them, I suppose, if you want to call it cheating, that they're hitting you like that and they're at minimum risk because they're at full stretch. So I suppose you could really yell at those people who do that, I suppose.
I wouldn't really yell at them, but I'd just try to discourage the practice.
I don't mean yell at them, I meant more like
Oi, hit me harder, mate.
Ever done LARP before? Now leave. Oh, is Now Leave in the room? Hello, Now Leave.
Now Leave is one of my regular viewers for my Twitch. He's always there, bless him. He's awesome. But I don't know if he's ever done LARP.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
Because I think Now Leave is from the Netherlands. And it's not that big over there.
Oh, what?
Not LARP like we know. They do the fairs and the festivals, and they got a massive one called Castle Fest that's coming up early August that I'm going to with Celine. Oh,
awesome.
Where they dress up and they do all the thing, and it looks amazing. But apparently, you know, Celine's had a look and she can't really find a lot of LARPing over there. But then again, I don't know how.
Now Leave is in the United States.
Who am I talking? Oh, I'm talking about someone else.
Uh-oh.
My bad. Oh, no, I know who I'm talking about. I'm talking about Check Your Facts. That's what I'm talking about.
You have some of the best named Twitch followers, mate. Fair play.
I know.
Twitch, all the best names.
Sorry, Now Leave, dude. Sorry.
Home of the free, land of the whopper. Yeah.
In that case, hang on. If he's in America, he has no excuse not to have LARPed.
Because there's loads. It is a metric boat ton. Yeah.
Wrong continent, Pete. Wrong continent.
Yeah.
Yeah, check your facts, bro. Check your facts, bro. Yeah, man. That's telling you. So I suppose that's my tuppence worth, as they say here in the United of the Kingdoms. Not so United Kingdom at the moment. You know,
I say we set up Brexit over LARP combat.
Oh, I'm up for that. Because Wales and Scotland would be pretty much even. Because we're mad Celtish gits. The English, don't think they're going to do so well in that. So I suppose,
there's a lot of them, though.
Mm-hmm. What, they look, do have the numbers.
Look, they built a wall in the end to keep us out. Let's be honest. Yeah.
Actually, that's true on both ends.
Yeah. So, you know, it doesn't matter if they got the numbers. We're crazy mofos. When you've got a Welsh guy standing there half naked in a kilt screaming at you, you tend to think about twice about. Just saying.
Especially, no! Especially, now leave! No, not tonight.
No, we're not doing that. We're not doing that tonight. This is a LARP show.
Maybe another day. No, we're not going to argue with Brexit. No.
I mean, this is a cluster, but not that kind of cluster.
It may have an F in the title.
Yes. And I'm trying to keep this safe for work for now.
Look, dude, this always goes NSFW eventually. That's why we have the adult tag. Because there's no way I can get through a podcast without swearing at least once. And as I was going to say, you know, with the English, let's be honest, half-naked Welshman in a kilt with a loaded sheep.
Game over, really, yeah, isn't it? Yeah. Game over.
You know. But, so yeah, that's my tuppence worth then for the tippy-tappy combat. And I can definitely see your points there, Tom, about new people, etc. Kind of being, I don't know how hard to do this, but that all, yeah.
And also a lot of it is because we don't always, I mean, I hate to defend it, but I also say that a lot of people don't actually LARP that often, so never actually get much practice in.
Well, that's it. Yeah, definitely.
You know, if you're LARPing 2-4 times a year, that's not actually, that's only effectively a few hours per session, really, yeah. If that. Mm-hmm. That's not a lot of time. You're not going to get super proficient.
Yeah.
That's really cool for maybe some kind of LARPing clubs to, you know, practice technique on. I'm not just fighting, but fight different ways of fighting, different types of fighting, and even role-playing stuff as well. How to do different types of role-play.
Yeah, role-playing's a big part of it, you know, I think, which I'm sure we'll get on later. I think the way you do it is just by experiencing it, and the more experienced LARPers just educating the ones that maybe not so experienced, saying don't be afraid to, you know, don't be afraid to make sure it makes contact, you know, get in there, get stuck in. Because I can remember, like I said, because I suppose you could say for me, me getting into LARP was quite recent compared to you two. I honestly was, I can remember it, I was very kind of cautious about going, getting stuck in.
Yeah.
You know, not just because I was playing a rogue kind of character, but I would always skirt around and I would run and go hee hee and then run back out because it was completely new to me. I didn't know what to expect, you know, and hey, it's your first character, you don't want him to die.
So Tom, what you're trying to tell me is that you are definitely a
pillow puncher.
I was then, I'm not now. Now I get stuck in.
Now I
bypass the pillow.
Now you like to make sure that everybody that you actually attacked is eventually
wrapped in plastic.
Yeah. In a way.
Oh God, fair enough. Okay, I think we've done that a little bit. I think we you know I'm happy.
Sorry, that's a chat room. Hash pillow puncher. Hashtag pillow puncher. I love it.
Hashtag. Do you know what? I saw that in a movie the other day. I've seen Central Intelligence with The Rock Johnson and the other one. I can't remember his name. Short dark dude, and the really stupid comedy guy in it. You know, does a hashtag. Right,
he ripped it off us.
Seriously,
he ripped
man.
It off us.
We are trailblazers. Right. Trailblazers is what we are, right?
Yeah, 70%. It's because we are hashtag LARPBook.
Yeah, I tell you what, I saw that. I pissed myself laughing more than the jokes that were actually in the movie, which there weren't that many. It's all right. It's not great. Maybe we should do a movie review thing podcast, guys. What do you reckon?
Actually, it'd be fun. Yeah.
Well, yes, it would. No, it wouldn't, because my input would be, it was all right. Or,
well, thanks for watching.
Yeah. See you next week for another exciting movie review.
Maybe we could do the shortest movie review podcast.
I reckon that would get loads of subscribers on YouTube. Basically, you do an intro and you come and go, it's all right. And that would get millions.
Or that was millions. Awesome. You know, two thumbs up. Or,
it's all right.
Or you'll have to go and watch this one with your missus so you can go and watch the next Marvel movie.
Yeah, that's the kind of review we need.
Oh yeah. My god, that'd be amazing. I'm telling you now, that would get so many subscribers.
Okay, yeah.
I'm telling
Sorted.
You now.
Sorted.
Okay, let's do it.
I shall set that up. Moving on. Nobody else nicked that idea, all right? I had it first. Copywriting it here.
Hollywood.
Copywriting it here. Stuart Edwards 2016. All right. Just saying. Right.
No one else will watch that. Yay.
So let's move on then to Hema and Larp. Am I saying that right? Hema.
I think it has, that is right. Hema. Hema. And I've heard it pronounced Hema, so.
It's not like he dot. E dot M dot A dot.
Well, it does stand for something, but
like,
it's
like S.H.I.E.L.D.
It's the LARP version of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Do you know what? I can never remember the E in S.H.I.E.L.D. Can you?
Espionage?
No, don't use espionage.
No.
I know it's the strategic homeland,
initiative.
Well, I think it's intervention, isn't it?
Intervention.
Or initiative. And then the E.
No.
I can never remember it. Then it's Logistics Division. And now Tom's looking it up.
Yep.
Can never remember it. And doesn't matter how many times I look it up either as well.
It is espionage.
Is it?
I was right.
Yay!
Supreme Headquarters International Espionage Law Enforcement Division. It was espionage.
Wrong S.H.I.E.L.D.
Marvel Comics.
That's a comic S.H.I.E.L.D. But in the movie universe, it's a different definition. Yeah, you're right, Nova Noah.
Leave your review in
enforcement.
Character. Enforcement.
Strategic Homeland Intervention Enforcement and Logistics Division.
There we go.
I was going through the comics.
Now Leave is there. Look, the acronym originally stood for Supreme Headquarters International Espionage Law Enforcement Division.
Oh, yeah, that.
Bloody hell, mate.
I agree, Pete. Bloody nerds.
That is superb. Well, thank you, Now Leave.
Do you know what I do love it when you guys actually get involved, because it gives us something to talk about. So anyway, Hema and Larp. Rob,
okay.
I have no idea what this is. You've chucked that in there. Rock and roll.
That's my turn. That's my fault entirely. That's because I've been getting rather hooked on Matt Easton's Schola Gladiatora.
Okay.
Or Gladiatora.
Right. Oh, right. This is
Schola Gladiatora. Yeah.
Schola Gladiatoria. Yeah.
Yeah. So Hema is historic martial arts.
Right.
So it's trying to figure out how people would have actually fought with swords and spears, shields, and all the various historic weapons and the closing and distance techniques they would have used.
Okay.
It's all basically about, really, when you think about it, it's trying to go, okay, it's not like sport fencing. That's not remotely realistic, the real fence, because it's going back and forward in two dimensions. That can't be right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there's weird rules in sport fencing. And it's not LARP because, we don't really try to figure out what people would have done. We've got our own ways of fighting.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it's actually trying to recreate lost, if you like, ways of fighting, because nobody uses them anymore.
That's quite interesting.
Right. So,
and there was a Hema demo at a couple of years ago at a LARPCon. And those guys really were good. Really, some excellent fighting techniques going on.
So what is Hema then? Explain that to me.
Right. Hang on. I'll get the proper definition up.
Homeland espionage.
Marshall. Yeah.
So when in doubt, Google it.
Hema. Hang on, that's a house where I stop. No!
Hema, you owe us some money now.
So it's
free advertising.
It's a style it's a style of fighting then, is it?
Yeah, it's an attempt. Yeah, Hema is an attempt to create it's historical European martial arts. So it's trying to recreate the martial arts from European history in particular.
Right.
So it's a group.
Okay. Right.
Okay, in other words, real sword fencing, real axe and shield combat, that kind of stuff.
Right. Do you know what? That would actually be quite interesting. Where are those guys based, Rob?
They're all over the place. There's clubs all over the country.
Right. Let's try and get them on the show.
That would be really cool to find out you know, just how, I don't know, knights of the medieval, how they actually truly fought and how, you know.
Yeah, it's really, really fascinating. Yeah. So Matt Easton runs the Schola Gladiatora YouTube channel. He puts out a ton of historical discussions about techniques or weapons or how weapons would have been held or what they were. And it's a really fascinating channel.
Okay.
But the reason I'm putting it up there is that he recently started doing a series of videos with a guy called... that's the word I'm looking for now. I've lost his name. Mark Gilbert.
Okay.
Now, Mark Gilbert's a name I kind of remember from the past.
Yeah.
And he's a really heavy. I know he's been involved in LARP for like ever.
Yeah.
And it turns out, something I didn't realize was that he's not only very good in LARP combat, but he's also a trained fencer. And he also takes part in Hema tournaments and as an instructor. They recently did a really, really good video. It's about half an hour long, talking about differences between things like reenactment and the Society for Creative Anachronism, and Hema techniques and LARP techniques. And a lot of it, it turns out, from that discussion, it suggests that there's a lot that LARPers can learn from people like Hema.
Yeah.
But because Hema is mostly one-on-one combat or small group combat, there's a lot they can learn from LARP because we do the big mass combats.
Okay.
Yeah, they could.
And we're not trying to, because we're not reenactors, we're not trying to recreate something or recreate a style. We're actually going for it like more like real people would have.
All right, okay.
I just find that whole crossover thing that we really perhaps should mention, perhaps we should learn more about.
Yeah. Let's get them on the show so we can discuss this a bit more in depth, I think, Rob.
Right. Yeah, okay, we'll try and get them on, shall we?
Yeah, definitely. I think so.
And I was wondering if you guys have actually run into Hema at all yourself, but it sounds like I'm the first one to encounter it.
No, the only Hema I've ever run into is hematology, something like that.
Uh-oh, bad news. So yeah, I've put the Schola Gladiatora link up on the show notes, and we've also got a link to this discussion I found on the Facebook page as well.
Okay.
And it looks like these two are going to do more discussions and more videos. In fact, there's another one that just came up today about historical inspired LARP. So I'll get a little article together on the website as well. And we'll try to get some Hema guys in, try to explain, and try to chat about the differences.
Okay. All right. No problem. I've got an article to go up as well, Rob, up on the site.
Awesome. Brilliant.
I've actually written something, Tom.
How long now, Stu? How long did it take?
Well,
2 years.
Not as long as I think, because I found out where the dictation tool was on my MacBook. So,
you talked to your computer.
Basically, chatted on my computer for a bit, and it was all good.
Fantastic.
But we may talk about that. It's not in the show notes, but let's have a little chat about that now. Okay. Here is my, because I'd like the chat room to get involved in this one as well. Basically, do LARPers, right, make better MMORPG gamers?
Oh.
No, come on, right?
Because, no, not necessarily.
Because we are used to the interaction and what have you that LARP gives us. So when we go on to an MMORPG... Yeah, like World of Warcraft, etc., yada, yada, yada. We're more engaged with the multi, the massive online bit, because we quite like being in that fantasy world and interacting with others. Forget the gaming, like the raiding and all the rest of that crap,
If you're talking about for role-playing, on role-playing servers, then I would probably agree, yes.
Mm-hmm.
But from LARPing that I've seen, there's very little organization on the player side.
I didn't say people would be organized. I mean,
oh, no, role plays are terrible. I think we will sit here, have a beer, and discuss what's going to happen 100 times over, and hopefully the things will just.
That nothing would get done.
No. Let me take this back. All right. It's not let's sit around the campfire, have a beer, and discuss it 100 times. Let's sit around the campfire, have a beer, and wait for the monsters to turn up.
Yes. That's what they would do, totally.
Let's be honest, yeah? It's like, pff, they'll eventually get bored and come to us.
Yeah. Totally. Oh my god. But no, I don't think they necessarily mean that they're better at MMOs now.
Okay.
Well, I mean, I don't know what part of MMOs you feel that they might be better at.
Well, interestingly enough, right, I have written this article. I'll pass it over to Rob so he can pretty it up and get some pictures on there and stuff.
Yep, I'll do my pictory thing.
You'll do your pictory thing.
Pretty pictures.
And when it goes up, have a read of it, right? And
okay.
And see what my what's the word, research.
Okay.
Come up. And
then, okay, yeah.
And then they'll like tell it, me whether or not you think it's my supposition is any different.
Never go to Goldshire.
Never go to Goldshire. Well, I don't know. It depends what type of LARP you want.
Especially on an RP server. Yeah. Well, a PvP RP server and stuff like that.
Oh.
Gank City. So, let's come off that. It was just a quick throw in. When I say throw in, LARP arrows and right.
No.
That
was shocking.
Naughty segue.
That gave me goose pimples right there.
Let's talk about LARP arrows and you. Now, someone did put a thing up on the Reddit LARP site.
Subreddit.
That's the one. Yeah,
subreddit.
Thank you very much, Robert, for reminding my brain what a Reddit and a sub was. The whole thing that when someone shoots an arrow at you, and a LARP safe one, I might add, yeah, what sort of damage can it actually do, I suppose? And I think we've all been... Have I been on the receiving? If I have, I probably ignored it. We've probably all been on the receiving end of a LARP arrow, in the wrong hands, i.e. mine.
Yeah.
I think it can probably do a bit of damage, if not damage, perhaps hurt in ways it shouldn't.
Yeah.
I mean,
the LARP arrows can. Yeah. Okay. So LARP arrows are safe, and I've never seen anybody sort of impaled with a LARP arrow.
No, that's right, yeah.
But they can hurt, yeah, I agree with that.
I used to be an adventurer. Yeah, no worries, but I used to be an adventurer like you until I got an arrow to the knee, you mean, Rob? Yeah, okay, right. I know I've caused some damage in the heat of the moment. Not damage per se, but I've definitely hurt a couple of people. Alistair, Lee, sorry. Alistair, I took his gonads out. Lee, yeah. I got straight in the throat. But that's the problem with me and quick fire anything. When I'm quick fire, I'm deadly. I always seem to hit things that would do major damage. When it's nice and controlled and what have you, I seem to hit center mass. Other than that, I seem to be taking out things that will... It's just my instinctual reflexes. Never catch me unawares. I might do you a bit of damage. You back now, Tom? Got your tea, mate?
I am. I've got a cup of tea now.
Fantastic.
Oh, very nice, yeah.
Because it's just the British thing to do, isn't it, dear boy?
Well, if we're doing a podcast, we need a good cup of tea.
Absolutely. Fabulous. Tom just likes smell you later, guys. Yeah, so I know I've caused a bit of grief with arrows. Tom, have you ever been on the receiving end of an arrow that's done you like type thing?
No, not really. Not one that has not yet. Anyway, but not one that has caused me that I can remember.
Yeah.
No. Actually, I haven't. It's not too bad with arrows. No, not really. I normally have a shield.
I would say the biggest problem, or rather the thing that needs to be addressed, I suppose, and I know the Lorien Trust addressed this quite a bit, All the bows need to be of a particular fairly low poundage.
Yeah.
I think that's pretty much universal. They
I think so, bows.
Yeah.
There's no point in having one other thing and having a friggin' British longbow where you need to pull it back with two people just to launch the thing.
Yeah, that's what I... Well, my bow is about £35.
Yeah, which is quite high for LARP.
Yeah. But I know that I just need to kind of half draw it, type thing,
and that takes it down. As long as you just do that, you're fine. Because if you do have a competition bow, I mean, a competition bow is what, 40 to 60 pounds.
Oh yeah, 40 to 60 pounds. I mean that it doesn't matter what freaking arrowhead you've got on that. A competition bow, it's going to hit, and the core's going to go through that arrowhead, right?
Mm. Yeah. Let's not get anywhere near what like a replica longbow or something will do.
No.
Go through steel.
Steel. Well, with the right head on, yes.
Yeah.
You know, because they've always said that it doesn't matter what armor is actually in body armor, etc. Whether it's Kevlar, whether it's the new ceramic stuff, etc. If someone's got a decent bow or crossbow, mainly a bow, with the right head on, that's going through. That just slices, man. Because it doesn't spread. It doesn't spread the impact. It just shears straight through. So, should you want to take out any bad guys in the future that happen to be wearing sort of vests, make sure you've got a decent self reloading crossbow at high poundage, and a lot of very sharp arrowheads, and you'll be golden. Yeah. Hopefully, like Deadpool, you can get them to line up. And save
so can be, But no, I mean, if you do get hit, I mean, I got hit in the face last year with a bow at a moderate range, not close, not really distant.
Yeah.
I mean, it definitely aimed my body, but it was combat. It hit me in the face, and that sort of, well, that just caused me, there's that moment of like a white flash where, what the hell has happened? Oh, yeah. My nose was hit. Oh, God, I'm bleeding.
Yeah. Well, you're in a physical
thing.
And I accept that because it's a physical combat, yeah.
You go into it knowing that people are going to... It's a physical thing and you could get hurt. And whenever something includes a projectile where you're not in complete control of, then accidents can happen, you know.
But I do think that sometimes people forget that LARP is basically a full... contact sport, if you want to go down
the combat element. Definitely a contact sport. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you can always like add like rules to help minimize that, which a lot do. You know, like some say you can't use a bow in close quarters. Makes sense.
Yeah.
Some say you can't use a bow again unless they've got a shield. Again, makes sense. Well, in some aspect, I say that's pansy, but there are some that are like that. You know, so like we said, you can do things that will reduce the risk of serious injury, and anyway, the chance of serious injury is relatively low, I would imagine, for it. But again, there's always a chance. Then again, there's always a chance when you go out and play football that you break your leg.
Yeah,
yeah.
I think there's more chance of getting seriously hurt playing football than you have LARPing.
Yeah, and that's technically not a full contact sport. I want to say full contact, flicking another player's ear, and he goes down on the ground groveling in pain.
Oh,
you know.
I still think if you want me to watch football, just give the players swords as well as a ball to kick.
Medieval football.
Do you have to wear goggles when you LARP so you don't get shot in the eyes? No.
No. No, that's part of the point of it, is that you don't wear protection.
Unless the LARP involves airsoft,
then you
have to.
It's the arrows. If you have a look at LARP, do a search for LARP safe arrows. You'll see that the actual heads are made of foam and silicone and what have you, and are big enough technically, unless you happen to have
but this kind of size,
big.
Anime size eyes.
I mean, Sailor Moon would be in big trouble.
That's right, yeah. You know, then technically they shouldn't do any real damage. But again, like I said, if the system has not put in the provision to make sure that any bows are of a particular poundage, then if you are using a competition type bow, then there is the possibility that when that foam tip hits, that the shaft continues, you know, and actually rip through the foam tip. But any LARP worth their salt is going to check bow strength.
Simple as that. Yeah, and there were a lot. Quite a few will also check the condition of bows and condition of arrows as well. Arrows do deteriorate fairly quickly.
Weapon
checks. I mean, all weapon checks are pretty standard. And again, if you feel that, you know, like you've been hit with an arrow and you go, "Fucking hell, that was a bit," just like I say, go to the ref and ask if they can check. And what they'll do, they'll just put and fire it at someone and see what they think. Yeah, right, yeah. Normally the guy will fire at the ref or something.
They will usually fire it at another ref.
Yeah.
You know, someone that's not been working particularly well that day. Or the new ref.
The rookie.
Hey, rookie.
Take your lumps.
Stand over there. I've been on the receiving end? Yeah, I probably have. But I'm so thick that I forget these things anyway. That's basically how my entire life works. I forget how much it hurts the last time I did it, so I go and do it again. You know, what happens when I put my fingers in a 240 volt? Ow. A month later, what does happen if I put my fingers in a 240 volt? And that's basically my life in a nutshell. You know.
Yeah,
blades.
You gotta stop putting your fingers in those sockets, dude.
Why does it hurt?
Well, you told me it did.
Can't remember.
Better try and find out.
I'll have a go later.
Okay.
So, I suppose. Okay. Yeah, they can hurt.
But I think that's fair. Yeah. And as long as people are checking for safety and making sure the bones aren't too powerful,
But then again, Rob, right, you know, swords can hurt.
Swords can really hurt.
Big maces can hurt. Having Rob run into you with a shield can hurt.
Probably, that's quite destructive, yeah.
Having Rob run into you can hurt.
Having Rob near you can hurt.
Yeah, anybody...
What's that?
It's the light I thought I... had some black in my eye, but it's just the light. And they go like, what the hell is that? Damn, the mascara's bleeding again.
Stu, look at the chat room. There's somebody whose name you've got to say.
Say my name, please. Okay. SebiKiller44.
There you go.
Did he get it right?
That's got to be SebiKiller. Or SebiKiller.
SebiKiller. I'm really hoping now in another language I haven't said anything dirty. But then again, if I have said it, I don't care.
Yeah, no, I don't care. It's all good.
You know, so hello, SebiKiller44. Welcome to the chat and welcome to the show. I think it's probably the first time you've been. So enjoy the ramblings that we do. So that's LARP arrows. And by the way, anybody that ever role plays with Rob, once he's got a little bit of momentum, he's a bit like that character from the Marvel, DC, whatever it is, universe that got played by Vinnie Jones. Juggernaut.
The Juggernaut.
That's the one. Yeah. He's a bit like Juggernaut. Yeah. Nothing basically stops him once the momentum gets going.
Stay out of his way.
Because it, trust me.
I can't actually stop once momentum gets going.
Yeah, exactly. He needs to circle the earth once to slow down.
And hopefully not in the wrong direction. Otherwise.
Yeah.
So let's discuss now alcohol.
The help. Yeah, actually, I bet that's quite close. That's fair.
Yeah.
I can't really argue with that.
I mean, we do, well... The nickname that I've had for him and Rob has had for many years is Robzilla. Because wherever he goes, he does seem to trash the entire place like a cheaply made Chinese or Japanese city.
Look, things are badly made these days. Yes.
For the Robzilla.
What? You mean like doors? You think doors are badly made?
You mean like solid walls?
Yeah. Well, yes, it's not made from like 18 inch or like 3 or 4 feet of solid stone. It's not castle strength. It, you know, that's the point.
I've seen you take out a small tree.
Oh, God.
Yeah, actually.
So you're trying to say that trees aren't made the same as they used to be?
Well, there is evolution.
Or is that leafolution?
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Yeah, so alcohol.
Yeah, yeah.
This is outrageous!
Now, for those of you that do know me personally, I used to drink. Okay, I used to have I used to like to have a drink, but not go over the top. Yeah, only once did I ever do that, and that was at a New Year's Eve party, and we shall never speak of that again, will we, Robert?
No, first of all, I also remember having your mum hunting me down.
Yeah.
Do you know where he is? No.
Screw it up.
Yeah. Well, I've no idea, Cheryl. I've got a clue where he is. Yeah. But if I see him, I'll let him know. Click to Stu. You better get your ass up your mum's, mate. So I think I was gone for 3 days when I.
Jesus, Stu.
Yeah, he was a lot younger then.
I was a lot younger then. Yeah, with not a care in the world. So I don't drink anymore, right? But alcohol is usually a solid feature at most LARPs that I've been to.
I would say most LARPs have alcohol. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest with you, when Fear the Dark was running, and I know Fear the Dark is coming back, folks. I have had confirmation on that. I will give more details when that comes up. But it'll probably just be for UK people unless anybody wants to fly over from the US or anywhere else in Europe. Even though it might be a bit more difficult to get over here now. In fact, Fear the Dark Games, I always said that they were sponsored by Carling.
Pretty much.
Because so much Carling used to get drunken at those events. It was ridiculous. Yeah. Slabs upon slabs upon slabs. There wasn't any food in any of the fridges in the Wilderness Center, right? And you've been to the Wilderness Center now, I think, Tom, haven't you? Yeah.
Yep.
You know how many fridges are there?
There's friggin' loads. And yeah, they've added more, haven't they, Rob?
There was no food in them.
There's a reason for that.
Yeah. There was no food in them. No.
Just booze?
Just mainly Carling.
The liquid diet.
It was, yes. So
maybe some bacon.
And maybe some bacon. Some bacon. Yeah. The bread you can put underneath, you know, on the things. You don't need the fridges for that.
Yeah.
But I'm okay with alcohol being at events and what have you, because, you know, on the whole, I would say events are fairly adult. If there are children coming along to events, you either have to have children that are okay with adults being a little bit drunk, and as long as you supervise them and make sure they don't get pissed themselves, or have no children there at all, I suppose, you know, purely adult LARPs. I have a slight problem when people go over the board. But I suppose I have a slight problem with people going over the board at any point getting absolutely and utterly pissed. Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's bad enough when your normal stuff's going on. And, you know, but when you happen to have a sword with a fiberglass core in it that, should they decide to stab, could do some damage. But then again, when they're that pissed, they're so slow anyway.
You could just, you know, like, just casually stroll to the side and they'll miss. Yeah.
But, you know, tempers do fray a bit as well when the alcohol is flowing. So, I don't know. I'm a moderation guy. You know, everything in moderation.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Rob, what are your thoughts? Because I could probably waffle for some time.
It's okay. Don't mind you waffling.
Why are you doing a podcast, man?
Yeah, man. Waffle. Best is to waffle.
Waffle, 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 waffle.
No, it's interesting. It's like, I like alcoholic games. I don't like not drunkenness. If that makes any sense.
No, it does.
I like to have drinks. I like to see people having a good drink. It's great, especially if you're in a, if you're role playing the kind of environment where people would be drinking.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Taverns. Yeah. Like you're in a bar or a tavern or party or something. Yeah. That's totally. And yeah, I like that. And I've noticed. I seem to notice that. I don't know whether because people are playing with getting older or there's some sea change, but it seems to be a lot less drinking going on than there was, say, 10 or 15 years ago or 20 years ago.
Yeah. Okay.
And I also know that I suspect that there's a lot less drinking in other parts of the world than in the UK as well.
I mean, the UK is awful for drinking. It's really part of the culture.
The UK is awful for binge drinking.
Binge drinking, I should have said.
Our European counterpart, I think they'll be drinking, but not getting absolutely for sake of their heads.
Well, look, I mean, when I did my combat course, we did it at... Luke's going to kill me. Andy's going to kill me. What's the name of the castle in Barry?
That's St. David's?
No. It's a funny name.
Ah, somewhere in England.
No, it's down Barry Way.
Barry Way.
Barry.
Yeah.
The funny name.
Yeah, it's got a really fun. Anyway, right. When we did that combat course down there, right?
Yeah.
You're both gonna be Googling this, don't know. Funny name thing in Castle yeah. Barry.
Down Barry.
And
Gibbons and, Down.
No.
Think Donuts.
No, it's not Gibbons Down.
That's a good name, though.
St. Donuts.
We'll just say that, yeah.
No, cool. It is. St. Donuts Castle. Pretty sure, anyway. And Kevin is going to kill me as well now.
By the way, folks, Kevin is a real swords master.
Yeah, yeah. If anybody have never actually seen this guy, have a look up at Kevin McCurdy. That's the dude that trained me. It's awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Yeah.
And he's doing a lot of work now with the Globe Theatre. So have a look at their combat, and that's all fencing is pretty much it. That's a lot of it is his.
Yeah, yeah. So it's all him. And when we were down there, they are one of like five places in the UK that has an international or a European bar, right? Which means that I think anybody from 13 and upwards can order alcohol.
What?
Mm. Yeah. It was very interesting to watch, actually. They are only allowed wine and spirits, no beer, no lager.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Right?
Okay.
And I tell you what a very, what's the best word I can use? The controlled, sensible.
I suppose they'd have to.
Group they were because they've been brought up with it.
Yeah, yeah.
And they were just ordering glasses of wine, etc. And going away, and I'm not chucking it down the neck like, you know, British teenagers would with their bottle of White Lightning or whatever the hell they drink these days. And we're very sensible and controlled about the entire thing. It was a marvel to watch, I'll be honest. do I want to know? Pimps, you guys. Okay. Who's the pimp then? You're the pimp, Tom.
Tom's the pimp.
Yeah.
Yeah. Apparently, I'm the pimp.
So you know, yeah. I would say that the Europeans then have a much better relationship than with alcohol. Mm. They don't seem to kick the ass out of it. Like the British do. You know,
a while ago, I had a really, really interesting experience. And this is going back a long time, so I apologize for the age of this comment, okay? I had a really interesting experience in Holland.
Yeah.
But we're not talking about that. We're talking about the other one.
Smoke weed every day.
here we go again. No, I'm not talking about that one. I was at a Worldcon.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've ever been to a World Science Fiction Con, anybody, or anybody's chat room, but at that point, there were parties every night trying to get people to vote for where the next one is going to be. And so that you had some European countries contending, you had some cities and states, well, European cities, you had some cities and states, and then you had, I think it was Edinburgh.
Okay. I love how you don't class that as a European city. Yes, some European cities and states and Edinburgh.
Well, Edinburgh is in a class of its own, let's be honest.
Come on. I mean, the Scots might like you, but they certainly don't act like
No, they tend to go, so this comes in barrels, right?
Yeah.
It was really weird because at one point, there were a bunch of people, there were a couple of well-known science fiction writers there.
Yeah.
For some reason, I can't be, it's such a long time ago, I can't be sure if it's true or not, but the names Harry Harrison and Terry Pratchett come to mind.
Right, okay.
Who were at an American party where they were serving Coke.
Right.
Okay, Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
More Coca-Cola.
Coca-Cola.
And they go, oh, okay, if anywhere we can go to get a drink, and I go, you need to go to the Edinburgh party. And they went off there, and we went off there, and yeah, it was like, you walk in, and an open tin goes immediately into your hand as soon as you walk in.
In fact, that is your admission.
Yeah. You have to have an open tin in your hand, yeah.
Yeah, before you can even get in, because otherwise, you know, you're just weak, as far as they're concerned.
Yeah. But yeah, there is a real different attitude to alcohol. I mean, I quite like having drinks and games. Yeah. I don't like stupid drunkenness, because it means people don't roleplay right, and they're dangerous in combat, and they hurt themselves, and...
Yeah. And,
but I like having it there, but not too much. But I know that the culture is going to be different everywhere.
You know, and drunk people, a large percentage of drunk people are dicks. Let's be honest. Yeah. I was always a very happy drunk, even more happier than, you know, if you think my normal happy is good enough.
No. This is hyper happy.
You ain't seen nothing until I'm actually drunk. I think that's why I don't drink anymore, because the world can't handle that much happiness.
It might be world if we do that. We can't have that.
You can't have that. I mean, you know, we got to keep the military industrial complex going after all.
Exactly.
Yeah. We've two drinks. We've got a team with an anti-fun person.
We won't mention who that is.
By the way, he's writing more spreadsheets. Oh. Not spreadsheets, I mean PowerPoints.
PowerPoints, Jesus. I mean, if you've ever heard of death by PowerPoint, this is annihilation by PowerPoint. The man's not right. So
what's wrong with a PowerPoint with a three-digit number of slides in it?
Everything.
Right. It's okay if your name happens to be Steve Gorman, but if it's not...
Yeah. Oh, and he doesn't just use one.
Yeah, or even our mate Andy Lappin. Andy Lappin does an excellent 300 PowerPoint presentation. because it's funny. we'll have to give you a link to a PowerPoint presentation that was ripped directly from Andy, right, by a comedian. Right, a comedian basically took his PowerPoint that he put up online years before, word for word. Yeah, as a comedy sketch of how not to do PowerPoint, and this comedian ripped it off, lock, stock, and two smoking. I'll send you that link sometime, dude.
Yeah, let's have that, and let's have that on the show somewhere at some point.
And I've even been featured in some of his PowerPoint presentations in Las Vegas.
Wow. Nice. Bloody hell.
And when I met his bosses, they were like, oh, I remember you.
PowerPoint guy.
Yeah, wasn't such a good meeting as they remembered me as the guy in the dress.
What the hell kind of PowerPoints is this guy showing?
You know. Anyway, moving swiftly on. Have we come to a conclusion about alcohol in games then?
Oh, well, I haven't said anything.
Then off to you, dear friend.
Yeah. I agree with Mr. Slobo about design a Microsoft Word. Yeah, you please don't design something in Microsoft Word.
No. So, Tom, alcohol, games.
Well, I don't really drink. personally. I might have some mead every so often, maybe like a cup or something like that. Well, I'll drink throughout the night, just one.
Yeah.
I'm not a big drinker, definitely not. However, from what I can tell, what happens normally with alcohol in the labs that I've been, is that people would normally maybe have some alcohol, but make it last throughout the night until it reaches about, let's say, midnight, time's out.
Yeah.
That's when the serious drinking happens. That's when everyone gets around the fire, and then that's when they start doing, when, you know, like the LARPing's done, there's not going to be any combat, you don't really have to think or anything like that, and they'll just keep on drinking like that. I could totally see how when people go away and they just drink the entire weekend, how that could be, well, not only annoying for other people, but also dangerous.
Yeah.
And I would imagine there are like some games where they would physically stop people from ever taking part, but not that, until they've sobered up or something.
I think that's right as well. Yeah.
Because like it's dangerous and you're ruining the fun for everyone else. Because like you said, Stu, drunk people, a lot of them are assholes. You know, it's out of their hands. You know, it's just lose themselves. And
what have you put up there, Rob? Let's have a look.
What's that?
I might have put a link up to some mead.
I like mead.
I'm not going to click that link because it'll open up in
holy in my... hell.
Tom, click the link. Okay, Catherine.
Lithuanian.
Here's the link.
Yeah, Rob.
Rob's... God. That might be the strongest mead I've ever seen.
That mead has the power to remove the power of speech.
That mead has the power to remove paint.
Yeah.
50%. That mead has the power to move a small car.
Dude, that's the lowest, right? And they don't believe in the percentage system, the volume system. They believe in the percentage system. So 50% of that will be alcohol. Right, it's not percent proof. It's not like percent proof is when you burn off the alcohol and the alcohol content that gives you the percentage proof. No, it's just percentage.
Forget that. It'd kill me.
It's how I introduced myself to Luke. By the way, to Luke and Becky.
Yeah, bad man. He handed Luke a bottle of mead to have some mead.
And Luke, being Luke, went mead. Excellent.
Yeah. Whop. Look. Was he blind for a few hours?
He did cough and splutter.
There was some interesting language.
He coughed and spluttered. Becky threw not a fit, but I did think her eyes were going to pop out of her head, bless her.
No, thank you.
That was my introduction to Luke, by the way, to Luke and Becky. That was my hello.
What a hello. It was one they'll never forget.
Yeah.
And when they almost died.
You know, and from that, things can only get better, right?
Well, yeah. That's, you set the bar low. It just gets better.
And, you know, and it worked for many, many years. It's how friendships are forged, my friend. Friendships are forged like that. If you can forge them in the fires of hell, yeah, then, you know, your friendship's good.
Oh my god.
I'm not going to comment on whether that's true or not. I'm just whistling a boat.
Yes, it goes up. Doesn't it go up higher than that, Rob? Doesn't it go up higher than 75%? I'm sure I'm
sure 75%.
Isn't 75% in like dangerous territory of death?
Hang on. I'll just go and check.
That depends if you want to power your car or not.
Yeah.
I thought after a certain percentage, it was literally poison. I mean, okay, it's poison anyway, but as in, you can die from alcohol poisoning if you drink this.
This is Lithuanians we're talking about now, right?
Yeah, hang on. I found the answer.
Go on.
There is a... this Lithuanian mead has its own section in Wikipedia.
Go on.
Why not? And yeah, they do confirm that there is a variant that goes. I've seen one that goes 75%. I haven't seen 95%, but they have. They do confirm there is a variant that goes 75%.
95% would kill you. That is literally pure alcohol, and that would surely kill you.
Well, look, people drink meths. What can I say?
Yeah, I suppose.
And they're so all right.
People are stupid. You know?
Hello.
People are stupid. It's like those people who eat the fish that could potentially kill you. Okay, I've got a fish here that could potentially kill you if you eat it. And I've got some cod. Which one do you want?
Ooh, the one that'll kill me.
Exactly. But this is stew.
But yeah. but that one, mate, you know, it tastes so much better knowing that there is a chance that you could possibly die.
Mm.
It's the whole survival thing, mate, you know. Once you've survived something horrific, you know, your adrenaline's pumping.
Yeah.
So therefore the food tastes even better.
Well, I suppose.
You know, it's
I'd rather just not take the risk at all. I'm quite happy.
Look, nobody said us humans were ever sensible.
No, most of us are
logical or sensible.
Let's be honest, the majority of inventions and things that we've ever come up with have been by pure accident, where we've gone, what happens if...
Yeah. Actually, what I really want to see is a Lithuanian and a Japanese person getting together and having that fish with that meat at the same time and see what happens.
Oh, my. See how lucky you can truly be.
That fish marinated in that mead.
Oh!
D-God.
That's dicing with death there. If you survive that, do the lottery.
Yes.
Instantly.
Because you're on a lucky streak there.
So there we go. The almond lionfish. There we go.
Yeah.
Thank you, now leave. You are a fountain of knowledge tonight, my friend.
Oh, lionfish, that's it.
You are a fountain of knowledge tonight.
Okay.
So speaking of stupid things, do LARP, do people LARP on cocaine? I'm sure some do.
Probably some people LARP on drugs.
Although I would say on the majority, on the whole, no, because the LARP kits cost so much bloody money in the beginning. They haven't got any money left for cocaine.
It's true.
I
have to kick my drug habit to get my LARP gear.
Yeah, but paracetamol isn't that expensive, though, is it, Tom?
No, it's not too bad. I have to go down to the Tesco value stuff, though.
Oh, well, you know. The 69p one.
Yeah.
69p for 1,000. I'm sure
they've got a line of paracetamol.
Yeah. Yeah, crunch it up.
Oh, yeah.
Damn, that's good.
Okay, we're still getting an NSFW rating again.
Do you know what? In my mind right now, like the one portion of my mind that comes up with this shit, let's go, do you know what? I bet that would probably work better than actually eating it. This works. I'm sorry, but it does.
Oh my god. Well, there is a reason you snort it and not eat it, I suppose. Get it in your bloodstream quicker.
Well, yeah. You know, that's why I like Solpadol. The fizzy one.
Yeah. Don't do drugs, kids.
Don't do drugs. Unless it's paracetamol and your mum gives it to you, then it's fine.
Yeah.
But only if mum gives it to you, all right? Or your dad, obviously. So, I think... Are we done with alcohol? No?
We're done.
I think we better move along.
You know what?
We're not done with the podcast yet.
I'm beginning to wonder what we've got in these cups, to be honest.
I love the fact that's a Disney cup as well. You got,
yeah, man.
Child-friendly.
So you're Disney and maybe Star Wars.
Well, now they're the same, mate. Disney, Star Wars. Star Wars is Disney. So technically, we both have Disney bugs.
We do, yes. What are you sporting today?
That's right. Yeah,
I'm sporting a Hampton Premier Blend cup.
Ah.
With tea in it. Well, there's not a tea in it anymore, but, you know, it was tea
in it.
Fair enough. Right, we've done alcohol then.
I love these hypothetical questions that Mistress puts.
She's brilliant. It's just a little awesome.
Yeah, she's awesome.
But what if your mum's a crackhead?
Then I think doing cocaine at a LARP event is the least of your worries.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, just make sure she's taking it out of a sealed paracetamol box.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's my tuppence worth. In that respect. Okay, so We've done that.
Help me LARP book.
We do have. Do we have a help me LARP book?
I don't know. You're the one in charge of the emails.
I don't remember one. Do you have one, Stu?
No, we don't have one. No one's actually wrote into the show for a little while. Oh. If you want to write into the show, larpbookshow@gmail.com. It's at the bottom of the window there, right? larpbookshow@gmail.com. Give us your questions. Give us your reviews. Tell us we waffle on too much. Tell us you want more waffling. We are here for you. Otherwise, we'll just carry on doing this.
Dear LARP book, my mother's a crackhead.
What should I do?
Yes.
So we don't have a help me LARP book this week. However, okay. we apparently do. We have a LARP bitch fest there, Robert. Or is it? Did you put that in there?
No, I think we were talking about that. Mentioned my early notes. That's where I think we should be talking about drum rolling and tippy tapping. So I think we've done that.
What's the problem with shiny?
Yeah.
What's that?
Oh, that's just me messing around. That's where I have a tendency. Okay. I have a tendency at LARP games, not in LARP games, actually, when I go, to get very distracted by things I suddenly see and not focus on what I'm doing. They're like, ooh, shiny.
Yeah.
Does anybody else have that problem? Does it drive you crazy?
Me and shiny are old friends, mate.
Yeah.
The only time I'm actually focused is when I'm doing work for you.
Yeah.
I'll be perfectly honest with that, you know.
Yeah.
Because I know I've got to get it done because you always give me no time to do it in. Stu, we need this today.
Uh-oh.
But hey, keeps me focused, mate. Laser focused.
Uh-oh.
I only stop at lunchtime to watch something on the telly, then carry on, you know.
That's a fair use of lunchtime.
Yeah, exactly. Right, should we go on to events?
Go on, we've got a few events here. Let's go for it.
Yeah, okay. We want to big this. Well, there's a few things we want to big up in quite some way. First of all is the South Wales Pirate event.
Pirate Festival.
Yeah, big Pirate Festival. Now, I'm going to be there.
That's one at Caldecott, right?
Yeah,
that's one at Caldecott.
Caldecott Castle.
That's Caldecott Castle between August the 19th and 21st this year.
Yes. Tom, you're going to be there?
I should be. Yeah, I should be able to go. That's before the event,
It's the weekend before, in fact.
Yeah, I should be able to go there.
Rob?
Oh, yeah, I'm there.
He was there before you said the sentence.
Sorry, he's already there.
I intend to be there.
Excellent.
I'd be a little bit involved in some of the background stuff anyway.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it.
Yeah, I'm going to be there. Luke's going to be there, if anybody remembers Luke from the older podcasts. He's going to be there. He is, in fact, the Mad King. Mad King George, isn't he?
He's playing Mad King George, wonderful character.
And this year he has a sidekick.
May God have mercy on our souls.
Yes, I'm going to be a sidekick, and we've already started the what's the word? The banter, the witty repartee, up on the Facebook group and what have you, just to get everybody into the mood. And anybody that has seen Luke and I together knows that hilarity ensues. A lot. So don't expect it to be serious.
No,
it's not going to be serious at all.
No.
I mean, it is going to be a fairly big event, though. I mean, numbers, hundreds and hundreds of reenactors and LARPers and cosplayers coming together.
Yeah. And there's cannons, and there's so much black powder there, they've had to get a special certificate.
Yeah. We are talking about, you know, hundreds of kilos now?
Yeah. It's
a black powder. It's incredible.
They've had to get special dispensation from the local council to let off as many cannons as they're going to. It looks to be an absolutely amazing event. Now, Rob, I don't know this. Does it cost people to get in?
It does. It does, but it's not too expensive.
Okay, how much is it then, Robert?
Okay. So the tickets for the festival.
Yeah.
Hang on a second. I'm just grabbing ticket prices and stuff for you now. Okay, a family ticket.
Yeah.
That's £17.
Oh, that's pretty good.
And day tickets, a single adult ticket is £5.50, and a single child ticket for a day is £4.
Oh, that's nothing, is it? You know.
So
that's a happy meal.
Yeah, if that. Yeah.
that's a good price.
You know.
Let's show it like this. That would not even get you into the cinema to see one film.
Oh, hell no.
No, God, no, not even close. And you can have a whole day for that. That's fantastic.
Yeah. Whole day of awesome pirate fun.
And also
the Crimson Moon will be there.
The who, sorry?
Crimson Moon.
So there goes your alcohol again. back to the alcohol conversation. This is a surprise. Nah. So if anybody needs details on that, what's the website they can go to, Rob?
They can go to the Facebook page, but there's also southwalespirates.co.uk.
That's nice and easy. southwalespirates.co.uk. Website designed by our lovely Robert, by the way.
Yeah, and you can pre-order tickets online if you want to as well, so that's nice and easy to sort out.
Yeah, cool, excellent. Last year's event was an absolute mega event. It went down so well that, in fact, they've done a few events now and gone across to other events, haven't they, Rob, all around the country as well. It was such a success. So, and they've upped the game from last year as well, massively. So,
yep.
If nothing else, it'll be funny.
Right, that is so big now that they've had to get a big castle.
Yes.
Yeah.
Pretty much. Yep. Yeah. So let's move on then to Twilight Realms. Is that the second son? Is it, Rob?
Yeah. That's second son.
Okay.
Which is the second game in the relaunch or the reboot of the Tempest campaign from Twilight Realms. It's another UK game.
Okay.
It's the 28th to 30th of October. It's set again now hosted in the Wilderness Centre by Mitchell Dean.
Cool.
They are definitely looking for more players and more crew.
Yeah.
They want to make this a really big event. I think prices are currently £70 going up next month to about 90. But that does include full board, so you'll be fully looked after.
Yeah. Okay.
You'll be fed, you'll be watered.
Yeah.
The facilities at the Wilderness Centre are just top-notch. Oh, you probably won't find better facilities in any site.
No,
they are absolutely top-notch.
It's got to be one of the best sites, certainly in this country anyway.
Yeah, excellent fight.
Yeah, super.
And
go on, Tom.
Oh, I was just going to say, and if you've got any other reason... if that doesn't persuade you, me and Rob will be there, so you know.
Yeah, come and say hello.
Come and say hello, grab an autograph.
Yes, they're not very expensive.
just usually a cup of mead.
That'll do.
So that's Second Son. We'll have all of these details up in the show notes as well. When Rob does them, obviously. So
That won't be too long, hopefully. So that's looking like it's a continuation on the Tempest campaign. It looks to be a lot of fun. And they really are looking for a lot of players. So
Yeah. And I think crewing is cheaper, isn't it? Isn't it 40?
About 40, yeah, for crewing. So it's a lot cheaper.
I've LARPed with these guys for about... I've gone to about four LARPs with them, right? Something like that.
Okay. Yeah.
And those guys are awesome. They're very welcoming for new people. They can help you along the way, ease you in if you've never been.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They're
fantastic.
They're a fantastic bunch.
Can you tell I'm kind of sugarcoating it for magic items?
Yeah, I am one of the best, but we'll make sure the refs see this and know that you are going for magic items.
So there you go, Jamie. Tom's going for magical items, mate, just to let you know.
Yeah.
So just keep them away from him.
And he's so wood as well.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Duh.
Lovely.
Yeah. Right, so the next one then is, of course, After the Heat Ray.
Ooh, I just love that so much.
A post-apoc... A, post apocalyptic post-Martians.
Yeah, I just love the idea. This comes from Gideon Lawrence of Wyvern's Tales of Labs, so I'm becoming quite a fan of those games. I'm becoming quite a fan of. Yeah. We've gone to quite a few now, Tom, yeah?
Yeah. I've only gone to two.
Yeah, but, I've only got three now. But it's good fun. Anyway, I just love the concept of this, so I had to put it up. Then I found out about it.
Yeah.
So the idea is, H.G. Wells, War of the Worlds, Martians have invaded the country, burnt down as much as they possibly can, being Martians.
As they do.
Yeah.
Martians. You know, the story has completed, which means the Martians are now dead from some germs.
Yeah.
But the country's in a mess, so it's post-apocalyptic late Victorian England after the country's been destroyed by Martians.
Okay.
Cool.
I just think that's a great idea.
So, it is. I would guess then, to a degree, possibly steampunky type style?
I'm thinking steampunky type setting, yeah. Yeah, the picture
which
on
Luke will love.
Which Lord, yeah. Luke loves steampunk.
Absolutely, he loves it.
Yeah. So I'll post up the link to the Facebook event. So I'll post that link up.
Yeah,
it's a day event. So it's in Woodbury Common, which I think is near Exeter.
I think so. I think this one's yeah.
Rob knows geography.
I think it is. I think he's actually right. I think it is near Exeter.
I've got a latitude and a longitude reference for it.
Hey, actually, if you have a map and part of the military,
you can find this one.
I'll be right
quite precisely.
Longitude. Where is it?
Go on, Tom. Do it.
Well, it's not that one for sure.
By the way, you know it's not called longitude, right?
Yeah, I know. I was just freaking BSing.
It's longitude.
Longitude.
Longitude. It's this way and that way.
I'm trying to Google it, but unfortunately, Google keeps taking me to New York.
What was it? Up the stairs and cross the landing, remember rightly?
Yeah, that's roughly it.
God, that's
right, let's just say it's near Exeter, sure.
Right, cool. Let's go with that. We'll put up
it's in the UK.
We'll put it up with the show notes. Anyway, before we spent half an hour looking for the longitude and latitude.
Yeah. And of course, it's their event. It's really cheap. It's just £10 in advance or £15 on the day. So.
Oh, fantastic. See, I mean, what a fantastic way to introduce yourselves to LARP. Go along to a nice cheap event. Go along to a nice cheap event. That's only one day. So if you've never been LARPing before and you're in the UK, or if you're flying over, if you've got too much money, then what a great way to do it.
So
do you have anything else to discuss, anything you two guys want to add?
I think I'm okay, actually. I think
no, I'm
been good.
Tom, tell the fine people how they can find you on the interwebs.
Oh, freaking hell, I thought you were gonna tell me to do the spiel then. I was gonna panic.
I still may do.
Yeah. You can find me on Twitter. I'm redundant_UK. You can find me there, and I do have a Twitch channel, which is twitch.tv/redundantuk, one word.
Yeah.
And I stream when I can and all that lovely jazz.
Does some cracking gaming, and he's actually very funny.
Thank you.
Unlike in this show. whenever you're on his channel, make sure that you mention the fact that he looks like Gregory House.
Yep,
He does.
A little thing may happen.
Yeah, the little counter goes up. which makes me laugh. Rob, how can people find you?
Okay, you can get me through LARPBook. So I'm always floating around the LARPBook website or at LARPBook, our Twitter account. Or on our Facebook page, which is also LARPBook. And you can also get me on Twitter at Rob Davis.
There we go. You can find me. I'm on Facebook, obviously LARPBook as well, naturally. I do have a Twitter account, which I go on to every now and then. Stuart J. Edwards, Stuart J. Edwards. You can follow me on there and see what we're up to. Facebook, I sometimes go live. Now they've got that facility. It's normally just to say good morning or have a rant.
Or you have it for breakfast.
Yeah. Coffee. Hey, I'm actually, I actually had toast yesterday morning.
Wow.
I tell you.
Toast.
Mixing it up. Mixing it up.
Honest to God, mate. Honest to God. You know, that's just the way that I roll.
So you could add that to the movie review when you say, all right, what did you have for breakfast?
Toast.
Tell you what, it'll work. There is a YouTube channel of a guy who just goes...
Honest to God,
he just sits there for about 2 hours going...
I've seen somewhere as well, there's a dude that's going around just with cash and just doing that. What's that about?
I don't know.
No, it isn't.
That's not even funny.
The Rainmaker or something like that.
Yeah, and make it rain.
You're right, and it's not even funny. He's just on a plane or something. He's just like that.
I mean, what's that? At least with the, you know, like, movie review, at least you get something out of it, you know? Yeah. You'll know if it's all right or, you know, stay home or something like that.
Yeah.
Straight to the point.
You know, a very succinct Rotten Tomatoes.
Yeah.
Or tomatoes, if you're in America.
Tomatoes.
I say tomato, you say tomato.
Ooh. That's an interesting question from Mistress LeBeau. Is that YouTuber you're talking about clothed?
Yes.
Yeah. You mean there's a naked one as well?
Oh, God.
What?
I hope not.
Oh, yes, he is, yeah.
I forgot to mention as well that I'm actually on Twitch. Tricky Hunter UK.
Yeah.
Every night, you know. Tom and I do Overwatch on there with a bunch of mates.
Although I haven't played Overwatch for ages.
I wasn't there last Wednesday. We'll have to be there tomorrow. On Wednesdays, we normally do that.
Yeah. That's fine. I kind of haven't played. I've kind of fallen out with Overwatch. Not fallen out. I just don't fancy playing.
Yeah, so we'll have to get back into that. It's funny with us.
It is.
With our group, let's be honest. It is funny. Yeah. Rob, mate, you're gonna have to get into it, you know, you're gonna have to buy Overwatch, mate. It's not
good. I have to get the Overwatch action, aren't I?
Because I tell you what, even though we're completely and utterly shit at it, we giggle like little girls.
Oh, good. That means I'll be up to standard then.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah. Most definitely. Right then, shall we kind of get out of here?
Okay, then.
Yeah, okay. Right, so a big thank you to all of our lovely patrons who make it a bit easier to keep this show going. Without you, we wouldn't be able to buy a few things that we got. Yeah, so we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. If you want to become a patron subscriber, go across to patreon.com/LARPBook and help us out. $1 a month, I mean, that won't even get you a macchiato supremo something or other coffee. Hell, it won't even get you Americano coffee, to be honest with you. So if you'd like to get in contact with the show, just email larpbookshow@gmail.com. if there's a topic you would like us to discuss or something cool you saw or fancy writing an article for the website, then email the show, larpbookshow@gmail.com. come on, we need you. Otherwise we'll just keep rambling on with shit that we found. Music was provided by Ben Sound at bensound.com. We do have a shop over on Redbubble. Just search for LARPBook. We can get a fantastic t-shirt like the one I'm wearing tonight. You can listen to this podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, YouTube, Twitch, and Podbean. And just search in whatever thing you use to grab your podcasts with and just search for LARPBook. We're probably going to be there. And if we need to be somewhere else, let us know and I'll look into it. Email again, larpbookshow@gmail.com. Visit the website at larpbook.com. News, reviews, fantastic stuff up there. You can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Google+. Search for LARPBook. You'll find us. It's as simple as that. And don't forget, if you have liked the show, then whatever you actually use to listen to it, then give us a review. Chuck up 5 stars or whatever else that they use, a thumbs up, a thumbs down, don't care, right? But just tell people about us. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching. Rob, Tom, as ever, Thank you for being here.
That's a pleasure.
Yeah, happy to be here.
So with that, we shall get out of here. Bye, all.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I miss my long hair.